Hi, everyone. The Alberta Junior Hockey League champion Brooks Bandits are getting set for what will no doubt be their toughest test of the season. The Bandits celebrated briefly with fans this week, then set out to prepare for the Penticton V's in Game 1 of the Doyle Cup tonight. The BC champions were the toast of junior hockey this season, capturing the title with ease out there in a season that included a 42-game winning streak. I said 42, Jackie. The V's boast a roster that includes three National Hockey League draft picks and 16 players committed to NCAA schools for next season. The Bandits say they aren't about to underestimate their opponent, but they also are a good team themselves.
Yeah, I mean, we have a great team, and I know Penticton's, they're very good. They broke every record they possibly could have this year in junior hockey, so a great challenge for us and something we've been talking about for a long time is we wanted to give ourselves the opportunity to play Penticton, so excited to have them in next weekend.
Game 1 of the Doyle Cup goes tonight in Brooks at 7 bells. The Western Hockey League Conference Finals begin tonight. In the East, Moose Jaw and Edmonton have waited 9 days to start after sweeping their second round foes. The Warriors are up in Edmonton for game number one tonight. The Oil Kings did not lose to Moose Jaw this season. In the Western Final, Portland visits Kennewick, Washington for game one of that affair. Team Canada was right back at it today at the Under-18 World Hockey Championships in the Czech Republic. Not an easy task for the Canadians today. They were facing the undefeated United States of America in the semifinals, and the Americans would get on the board first in this one. JT Compher will just squeak it past Matt Murray. 1-0 for the U.S. The Canadians get it right back here, though. Damon Severson with the shot from the point. Jamal Smith gets a stick on it. In front, we've got a 1-1 game. The Canadians had their chances. Felix Girard with the steal. Moves in, and Colin Olsen just gets a piece of it. A little later, Canada with another steal. Smith will get around the American defenseman, but he can't beat Olsen, so we are still tied up at ones. Third period now, and the Americans regain the lead. Shot fired wide. Kyle Osterberg picked up the loose puck and beats Murray on the wraparound. That makes it a 2-1 game. Later in the third, Girard is nailed by Ryan Hartman. That should have been a major penalty for a hit to the head. The ref says it's a minor, and the Canadians failed to convert on that power play. The U.S. beats them 2-1, so Canada will now face Finland for the bronze medal on Sunday morning, in the wee hours of the morning, no less. The States will meet Sweden for the gold medal also on Sunday. Two National Hockey League teams need victories tonight to stay alive in their respective first-round Stanley Cup playoff series. Pittsburgh has to win to force a sixth game against Philadelphia. Face-off in that contest is in just a few minutes on TSN. Detroit is also facing a 3-1 series deficit against Nashville. Game 5 of that affair goes tonight in Music City at 6 o'clock. Baseball fans in Boston are celebrating the 100th anniversary of Fenway Park today. Fenway opened up on this date 100 years ago when the Sox beat the New York Highlanders by a count of 7-6. Today's opposition is also coming from the arch-rival Yankees, who were originally known as the Highlanders. All kinds of Red Sox alumni were there today to pay tribute to the venerable ball yard. The biggest cheers, though, were reserved for the members of the 2004 World Series champions, who were led by Kevin Millar and Pedro Martinez today.
Fenway Park, we want to thank you for the last 100 years. And the next 100 years. 100 more with a lot more success in Boston. To all of you, muchas gracias. And we're still making history. And one last time, it's time to count.
I think they were attempting to break a world record for largest toast ever. Now, the Yankees were in the process of ruining festivities at Fenway by beating up Boston 6-2 in the top of the ninth when I came in the studio, Jackie.
Ooh, okay.